Hello, chickens.
The noise. Hey! One of the noisy. One of the more noisier places I could shoot a video. Here with sunshine. So, recently I posted a video of me snowboarding. Ow. Hey! That was my nipple. I need everybody to chill out. Shush. So, after sharing some recent snowboard footage of myself, I had a ton of people request a GoPro color grading tutorial. And by a ton of people, I mean absolutely nobody. Nobody requested this video, but I decided I'm gonna make a video regardless and kind of give you guys the rundown of like how I color grade my GoPro footage, specifically in the winter time, and kind of the best overall practices with wintertime GoPro footage. Enjoy this little chicken B-roll, and we're gonna jump in the computer and see what damage we can do. Used to sell some matter roll pads. If I didn't hear my DMs, why she trying to get me sprung? Damn, this shit is fun. Let me double up my funds. Yeah, this sussy boy's done. Sorry that I swung. Trust me, sussy boy. Yeah, heard you need a bandage. Glance in my bank statement, think I really manage. Huh? He changed a couple K. Yeah, I do this every day. Let me pull up on your B. I'm kinda cutthroat. Check my duffo. Lady got a bubble. But she need a muzzle. Better have a hustle. Doink, scoop. Yeah, I'm down on my luck, go. I don't give a fuck, oh. On a dollar, let's start going Geico. Keep my money exponential, that's my only motto. 24/7, 649 lotto. Hey, you know I don't smoke, but
okay,
I'm
okay. Oh. There we go. Okay, so before we jump into the editing, let's go over a few kind of basic things that you want to keep in mind when you go out and shoot on your GoPro. I'm going to try to go through these pretty quickly just so we can jump straight into the computer, but I thought I would mention them just so we're on the same page. Okay, first off, when you are shooting, try to prioritize a sunny bluebird day. Editing in a snowstorm is going to be a completely different style of editing. You're going to be playing with your exposure way differently. And not only that, but the bluebird day is going to give you way better highlights. It's going to give you way better shadows, and it's going to give you way better color to work with. If you're shooting on a day that's a little bit darker or snowier, it's just kind of a different editing style. So try to shoot for a sunnier day. Now, when it comes to the resolution that I like to shoot in, normally I shoot in 1080 at 120 frames per second. And this just allows me to have really smooth slow motion. But recently I've been actually shooting in 2.7K at 60 frames per second, just to up the resolution. I know GoPro normally shoots at, I think, like 4K 60 frames per second. So it really just depends on which GoPro you're using, but 1080 at 120 frames per second is a safe bet. Now, one of the most important features that you need to tap into on the GoPro is the ProTune settings. ProTune feature is basically the manual setting that GoPro has. So you can set your ISO, you can set your shutter, you can set the color, pretty much everything. And this is important because it'll give you the ability to lock in your settings so they're not changing or trying to adjust automatically. And typically what I'll do is I'll change my ISO. I'll keep the minimum at 100 and then the maximum anywhere from 300 to 400. This will help keep it from getting overexposed and it'll keep it in the right exposure. Okay, so next I like to put it in GoPro flat or just flat. This is just gonna give you more information to edit with. So better shadows, better highlights, and better colors. And besides those, pretty much everything else put in just the default. Sharpness, I keep it in low. And what I'll do is I'll put a kind of cheat sheet up on the screen right now, which kind of shows what GoPro uses on their video shoots. So as you can see, 4K at 60 frames and then ISO 100 all the way up to 300 to 400 range. They actually use GoPro color on this, but I think since then people have said that the flat is almost better or gives you more information to work with. Okay, so that's kind of the basic settings that I usually work with. I don't want to waste any more time. Let's jump in the computer, do some editing. I'm going to play the actual video here for you guys to review and kind of see the final product. And then we'll go in and select some of the individual clips to play around with and tweak certain settings. So sit back, enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys on the other side. Okay, so now that we are in Adobe, I've chosen three separate clips from that sequence for us to edit. So here's what they are, you know, with the preset that I have made. So there's off, on. It's a pretty good difference. So what we're actually gonna do, I'm gonna delete these completely. So we're just gonna start from fresh, no presets. So we're gonna go over here, new adjustment layer. Throw that bad boy on there. And then since all these are shot in the same light, we're just gonna pull it all the way across all of these and then we'll just adjust individually. So first off, what we wanna focus on is our snow right here. Is the exposure looks really good. We're gonna go into curves. We're just gonna do basic S curves. So we're gonna bring down the shadows a bit, bring up the highlights a little bit. Okay, and see the curves already makes it look even better. Usually I'll bring down the blacks and then I'll bring up the fade a little bit. Let's see here. Okay, so you can obviously see we're kind of falling out on these blacks. So I'm gonna pull this back up a bit so we're not going too deep with that. That looks a little bit better. I usually like to bring down the whites up on this end a bit. It just kind of gives it a softer white. Next, I like to play with the blues. Usually I kind of go more into the kind of teal realm of things, which you can jump right over in here and grab this guy, this blue mark. I'll just pull these right up here. It's a little bit too crazy. So there's that color difference there. So we're already getting pretty close to where I like to land. I really don't do too much post-processing when it comes to my GoPro footage. Again, it's all about kind of nailing it in camera because the GoPro cameras do so well nowadays that you really don't have to do too much. It really just comes down to personal preference. As for like the trees, we could probably play around with those and give them maybe even more of like an orange, like, let's just see what these can do. Could give them a little bit more of like an orange. So it gives it kind of that teal orange look. That's a little overkill, but I mean, it looks kind of cool. All the trees look dead, but we'll just bring these back down, honestly. Dope. Okay, so what I'll do, let me just render this one out real quick so we can watch it. Okay, so now that it's rendered, here is the final product. Yeah, so it looks really good. I would say overall, I think exposure looks really good. And like I said, I really like how the whites are a little bit softer. They're not as harsh to look at. So yeah, overall looks pretty good. And then onto the next clip. So since it's the same adjustment layer, we just have it across onto this other clip. Usually I'll cut, trim it up right there, and then adjust on this one. This one also already looks really, really good. So again, doesn't take much to make them look good. This one, I honestly don't even know if we change anything. Maybe bring down the highlights a little bit. But for the most part, here is the final product on this one. Cool. And then this final clip here, this one we're in the shadow, so it is a little bit darker. But I think in general, you know, we could brighten it up, but then it's going to overexpose when I come in the highlights here. So I think this one also, we're just going to keep where it's at. Cool. And here is the final clip for this guy. So yeah, overall, everything looks really good. And I would say 90% of that is really just comes down to getting your settings correct and kind of applying those basic rules like weather settings, just stuff like that to make sure that you're really not doing much in post. We'll definitely have to play around with this maybe on a powder day when it's not as sunny and perfect conditions, because that is a whole kind of different level of finding the exposure and you know, saving the details when you're playing with your lights and shadows. But for now, this one looks really good. So let me know what you guys think. Let me know if you guys have any suggestions on what I could do differently maybe. I plan to do some more of these in the summer as well. So maybe some cool like cliff jumping videos or even some like lifestyle camping type stuff. But for now, I will leave you guys with this. Let me know if you guys have any questions in the comment section. But we are slowly coming up on 900 subs, which is super exciting. I think we're like 18 people off. So really excited for that. So make sure to subscribe. Make sure to like the video if this one was somewhat entertaining or educational. Thank you again for watching, guys. Let's hit that 900 subs. And I will see you on the next one.